M-A-L-T-A, can I get a M-A-L-T-A? Welcome to a special vlog. I'm on 0 hours of sleep. I'm in Malta. The electricity in my room isn't working and I'm sweating like a pig. And they said they were gonna send someone up 10 minutes ago and that person is still not here. However, why is this a special vlog? Because this is gonna be a festival vlog. I'm doing like 10, 12, 14 festival outdoor things this summer. Wouldn't it be cool to show you how different they all are? 6, 7, 8 per video. Good luck, Nate. And ranging from countries, but also ranging from the type of festivals, but more importantly, the type of sets that I play. Some places I'm gonna be opening, other places I'm gonna be headlining, and some are gonna be super small, some are gonna be really big, and the places where I'm gonna be staying at are gonna be super different according to what role I play at the festival. We start off at Malta. It's my first time here. I'm here for Annie Mac Presents Lost and Found. Let me show you the room. It's gonna be a really short one. Like a basic holiday, all-inclusive holiday resort. So it's full of just old British white folk doing up all-inclusive. Gorgeous, honey. But not much to say. Okay, the maintenance man just came. I really hope this air conditioning is gonna work because
it's hot.
I'm sweating balls. Anyways, it's my first time in Malta. Now, if you know me, you will know that I'm a woman of the world. I know my countries, I know my flags, I know my languages, I know their history, I studied history. I'm gonna confess something really embarrassing to you. I was today years old when I found out that Malta is actually a country on its own. And it's not a Spanish island, which I always thought, but I wouldn't be me if I didn't do my research properly. Malta was under the British rule and became independent in 64. And then they joined the EU in 2004. And it is an archipel and they lie between Sicily and the North African coast. They have their own language, it's called Maltese. Does that mean that people from Malta are Maltesers? I don't know. But I see these signs at the airport and look like it said Merhaba, which is obviously Arabic for welcome. But it's also in Turkish. Anyways, and so their language, Maltese, is this strange mix on the first eye between Arabic and almost Croatian. Anyway, I'm Lost and Found Festival. I'm here on no sleep. I got here at 11. I landed at 11. I depart again at 8 in the morning. And I am one of the first sets at one of the night parties. So there's like an opening act and then there's me. I'm just going to take you along. I was going to go to the pool party, but honestly, I haven't slept. So what I'm going to do is, I think they have a rooftop. And if it's not taken, I'm just going to tan on the roof. And if I have to, I'll go to the freaking beach because apparently that's really close. So yeah, let's go. No, because the fit check today is crazy. Adidas and Wales Bonner with the Adi shoes. Like, is she here to play tennis or is she here to play records? Okay, goodbye.
Look what I found in all her glory. This is cool.
You gonna be in it though?
What's that?
Indian family photo. Photo! Right, first festival done. I was supposed to leave at 11 so I could get a good night's sleep. It is now 3 o'clock and I need to get up at 5:30. Ooh. I can say that the first one was a big success. I started off with about 10 guys, topless, front row, who actually flew out to see me, which, bless them, and ended up with the whole space ramo. And not just saying it for the sake of it, I stayed for hours and hours after, and it wasn't that busy after that. So Q and I, DJ Q, who was on after me, and I had like the best crowd. I made loads of new friends, those guys front row. We just stuck around. I gave them my tequila bottle, I gave them my vodka. I Had a Dream was there, Sherelle was there, my G Reggie was there. Got to meet Annie Mack, we chatted for quite some time. It was so nice. And I will sleep when I'm back in London. And then the next place I'm gonna take you with me will be Milan for the IKEA festival.
Buy it, use it, break it, fix it, trash it, change it, melt, upgrade it. Buy it, add it, break it, fix it, trash it, change it, melt, upgrade it. Chart it, point it, zoom it, press it, snap it, work it, quick, 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 quick. Write it, cut it, paste it, save it, load it, check it, quick, rewrite it. Plug it, play it, burn it, rip it, drag it, drop it, zip and zip it.
Room tour. Second location of our festival tour vlog, and we're in Milano. And how insane. I'm staying at the Enhow Hotel, and to be really honest with you, I've got no clue what part of the city we're in. I'm thinking I'm not very central, but we're here for a really special gig. I said in the first part of this vlog that it's all outdoor sets that we're gonna do. So this isn't so much a festival. I mean, it is called festival, but it's, let me explain. So it's Milan Design Fashion Week. No, crackhead, it's Fashion Week next week. It's Milan Design Week. So it's all about design, form, function. All the biggest brands are all here. They have all their own like corners and stands and activations and exhibitions, and it's insane. Like, as you can see, it starts in the hotel. And I'm here because I've been brought out by IKEA, and I'm literally the headliner of tonight. They have a headliner every night. And I'm the headliner for tonight. So after a whole day of IKEA activations, which started in the morning, and presentations of the new collection, they've even done like some like affordable hi-fi designed in collaboration with Swedish House Mafia, which looks like this fancy record player, all kind of cool stuff. And previous headliners have been people like Jamie XX. Like, I mean, previous as in yesterday or tomorrow. And I'm the one of today, which is insane. I'm just gonna take you with me. Let's have a little walk around the base and then take you with me tonight to the actual festival. I'm running on 4 hours of sleep, but it's so hot outside. It's 31 degrees, so I feel like let's get out now. Let's have a little look at what these activations are, catch a little bit of Milan Design Week, and then come back and recuperate. Oh, and the mayor of Milan's gonna be there. That's a little bit insane.
Drag it, drop it, zip and zip it, lock it, seal it, curl it, find it.
It's 32 degrees. It's gorgeous.
View it, code it, jump and lock it, surf it, scroll it, pose it, pick it, cross it, crack it, switch, update it, name it, date it, tune it, paint it, scan it, send it, fax, rename it, touch it, bring it, fade, watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, format it, touch it, brand it, fade, watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, format it, touch it, brand it, fade, watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, format it, format it. Drop it, zip and zip it, lock it, seal it, curl it, find it, view it, code it, jump and lock it, surf it, scroll it, pose it, click it, cross it, crack it, switch, update it, name it, rate it, tune it, print it, scan it, send it, fax, rename it, touch 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 it, lock it, seal it, curl it, find it.
But I mean, he is fucking Jamie XX. Look at the green room situation. How cute. My baby cousin! Right, Milano done. That was a fun gig. It was random in the sense that when I got there and the guy before me was playing, there was literally still like no one. Everyone was still wandering around, getting food. And then I started playing, and slowly but surely the crowd started gathering. And really the first hour was me proper trying to figure out
what the fuck to do music wise and couldn't, like, you know, it's just like a mix of like small group of people who are really there to see you, and then a large group of people who have just registered because they want to show up to everything for the whole week of design week, and then a group of people who registered or just were still there from the earlier part of the day and didn't register but just kind of stuck around because they were already inside. But yeah, the second hour we nailed it, and it went off like they wouldn't let me go off stage, and it seemed like the people from the festival and IKEA and the agency were really happy and impressed. So if anybody from IKEA sees this, can I please get some like IKEA discount? I buy everything from IKEA, or even just like lifelong free meatballs, that'd be great. Off to Hamburg tomorrow, so yeah.
Please don't ask again who's up in the van. They my only fans. I was in my hovercraft, had another laugh. How you roll with them when you know I'm him? Got it on.
We are in the sunny Hamburg, my favorite city in Germany. Yes, over Berlin. Sorry, I said it. And you've just seen my hotel room, and I'm headlining an outdoor, like an open air party of what is usually a club called Chief Brody. And this is their first open air that they're doing, I believe. And the sun's out, which in Hamburg is not, it's kind of like London. You don't know what you're gonna get with the weather. I was super excited. However, I am knackered. I've just realized earlier on the way here that it's been four nights in a row where I've not slept more than 3 hours. And actually last night I didn't sleep at all because my hay fever kicked in. I left at 6 a.m. to go to the airport and was delayed to fly to München. And then I had an hour layover in München, got my hay fever tablets, then boarded the flight, fell asleep, woke up, we were still on the ground, and I thought, sick, we're here. No, we still had to take off. So it's just been a bit mad. And today, when I got to Milan airport, the places that could potentially do gluten-free food were all still closed because it was so early. So all I could have was like, literally, it was like a tomato with a ball of mozzarella, and that's all I've had in the last 35 hours. No, 48 actually. So that's not okay. Health and making sure I'm in a good state of mind for a good set over going out and exploring. Now, I've been to Hamburg many times. I wish I could have taken you with me, but sorry. I wanted to order mad room service, but their room service doesn't start. They do breakfast or dinner, and now it's in between the dinner time. So I've got a muffin in my bag. I'm gonna eat that. I'm gonna try to sleep for... Oh no, that's annoying. Why is there water coming out of the shower head? Anyways, I want to sleep for 2 hours, so 4:30. This is getting way longer than it should be. Okay, bye.
The one it was a bump. Joking, dropped my setting powder.
Okay, fit check. Basic white tee that I need to actually decide whether I want to use this for merch or not. These Joseph pants from Arta. They're men's. I think they're a size 32. They fit like a glove. It's amazing. But it comes with this jacket. Hold on. You could wear it open, I could wear it open. But maybe on entrance, I'm gonna wear it closed, which would look like this. I'll just turn the lights on so you can see it better. Look how cute. This is gorgeous. Stop.
This is all actually from film sets. As you can see.
This is cool.
Everything you see here was used in films. And you can actually rent those pieces.
For my vlogs. For my YouTube vlogs.
Kommt bitte alle, wir können auch mit euch feiern. Ich glaube, Shari und wer legt noch auf? Dankeschön. Liebe, Hatte, Ahoi.
I have to now move all the equipment and take it to the club so they can open the club for the after party.
That's right.
And Shafiq has to do everything by himself.
all alone.
All by myself.
All by himself. For free.
For free.
It's honestly a disgrace. City of, or the town of Genk, which is in literally the countryside of Belgium. It's like a mining town, an old mining town. Had to drive through like a whole forest. I thought we were in a get out situation. Room with twin beds because I was supposed to have a really romantic, pretty double room. And my friends from Amsterdam were giving me the idea that they'd come along, they'd take a train to Belgium and join me to this festival. And now they've bailed, even though I then got them. I got the promoters to like literally switch to a twin room, made them go through all this effort for them to not even pull up. And now I have to sleep in one of these stupid little beds.
Anyways, we're in Belgium and I am going to play at Afro-Latino Festival, stop 4 of our festival tour. And today I'm playing a stage at a festival called Afro-Latino Festival. And yesterday they had people like Tokisha Popola headlining. Today they've got, you know that guy that did Trinka, people like that, it's lit. And I'm playing at 9:30 p.m. fucking great time, basically like headline time, at a lemonade stage. And I'm playing after Jael, who you would have seen in the Razzmatazz Barcelona vlog. And before him is Full Crate, who I went to high school with. So it's like a little Amsterdam Netherlands reunion, which is gonna be really cute. And who you just briefly saw for a second. I was sitting next to that guy on the Eurostar. And I remember thinking the whole fucking train is white. What is the coincidence of this guy and I being the only POCs on the train and we're sitting next to each other? Then also, I like started doing some record box stuff and he was just listening to music, fell asleep. His music was so loud, but it was like, he had some sick tunes. And I thought, what the hell? Anyways, never spoke to him, got off the train and then found my driver. And the driver was like, we're still waiting for one person. He's also coming from London. And I think he was on your train. I said, I joked, I was like, I bet you was the guy that was sitting next to me. It was him. It's bloody Jamie Rodigan. An hour and a half car journey to this hotel here. And we had jokes. He's closing one of the bigger stages. So hopefully I get to see his set because, I mean, that's like a real DJ. So that'd be cool to see. Anyways, I'm gonna take a shit and then I'm gonna get ready and we're gonna go to the festival, yay. It's so cold here. I've got goosebumps in the hotel room. I left London in 29 degrees and it's 24 here. Sorry, I thought I had time to sleep and stuff. It's 4:45. We get picked up at 6. I need to get changed. Ooh, don't look at my nanny. Don't look at my nanny. Do I play during sunset? Anyways, I had to ask Jael, who's leaving the Netherlands now, to bring me a jacket. Also, I'm sorry, yeah, but why are the beds here and then the TV is... Oh my God, the cab's already here. I'm trying to show you my outfit. Hold on. Fuck. Ah. And I didn't even bring a jacket. Fucking twat, bro. Head to toe AGR. No jacket, but Jael's bringing me one. Bags from TK Maxx and... I look like a bag of Skittles. Okay, let's go. And they're taking the piss. Who's this bitch?
have enough tickets to get food. And I don't realize we just played the best set of the whole festival. The whole festival. This is racism. This is Get Out. This is our version of Get Out. You see this shit? We're begging for chicken. Chicken!
Get out of my way, bloody woman.
Hey. No, this is sad.
Yeah, what is sad? What is sad?
Because we can't get food.
Okay. We have Greek
it's
food.
It's not brood.
Greek food, but
it goes on brood.
I'll go McDonald's after this. It's really nice. It's legit shit, gewoon. Legit shit.
It's gewoon kip op een stokje, but it's lekker.
Yeah, man.
We're drunk. We're trying to find drill.
Yo, everybody try to see me DJ, bro.
Yo,
it's going crazy right now.
It's going crazy,
it's going crazy right now, bro.
Me and my vibe.
Reggaeton. He said, we don't know.
I'm in love. I'm in love. I'm in love. Oh my God, I'm in love. I'm a groupie. I'm in love.
Another successful set. We went from a not full stage to a full stage. I lost my voice again.
Okay, we're checking out. It's the next day. I'm wearing the shortest shorts known to mankind and sort of kind of have my nips out. So I'm really glad that Jael brought this jacket, even though it's hot outside. I am still in a country town for conservative white people. It's time to check out. I wanted to pop out to a pharmacy and get some razors because my chin hairs are having a field day and I don't want that. Plus I'm not going straight home when I get to London. But then I realized it's Sunday and the shops in towns like this are closed on Sunday because they love Jesus. So I'm just gonna have to pray that when we get to Brussels, where I'm gonna jump back on the train, that they'll have some. Anyways, recap of yesterday. It was so fun. I got a lovely message from the promoter saying, I wish more DJs and artists were like you. You were amazing to work with, blah, blah, blah. Can't wait to have you back next year. It was really good. Our tent was like, I think the smallest tent at the festival. And when I got there, it was very empty. And then I feel like when it comes to Full Craig, Jael and I feel bad for Full Craig because he played a great set. But because the sound engineer was breathing down his neck about the limiter, he kept turning his sound down and every time he did, people would leave the tent. So he actually ended his set with less people than he started with. But then Jael went on and the promoters had already had a conversation with the sound engineer and I just fucking bumped up his volume and it was great. I hate saying it, but I forgot to say it. Then I went on and I packed out the tent. It was great. It was amazing. I even had kids, like children, in the crowd. Anyways, yeah, that's Afro-Latino in Belgium done. Next week, we are in Copenhagen, which I still haven't booked flights for, and now the flights are a grand.
They always turn up late, and then they want to finish early.
Is this the reputation we Dutch people have?